Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I talk about fragrance. And welcome back. I'm such in a good mood today. It's around 10 o'clock, but I've been just out of a lovely live with the fragrant apprentice George, and there was Claire from Smurfy Girly, there was Peter for Fragrance View, there were Chris from Fragmento, Nigel from Two Cents Worth, and it was really lovely. I love those people, I love them. Beauty of fragrance community, positive move all the time. So now today we're gonna talk about the 10 fragrances that made my 2020 year good. Hey, let's start. So the first one was actually a fragrance that I had just recently, and it's called Naxos from Serjoff. It's got a very fresh opening with like some citrus vibe, and then it directly dries down to something vanilla-like, a lot of tobacco, so it's quite smoky. But more of that, you smell more the comfort, the warmth. Quite sexy when you smell it. That is quite powdery, I would say, at the end. It's comfortable, it's comforting. For me, an ultimate fragrance for someone that wants to feel charming, a bit mysterious, ultra luxurious. So that's one of my highlights of this year and my first Serjoff fragrance. So I'm gonna wear it like more during the evening or stuff like that. But it's been a whole year I was waiting to get this fragrance. So I'm really, really happy about it. And I think it's expensive, okay, but I think it's really worth it because it smells so luxurious and it smells also something different. It's not the kind of vanilla that you always smell all the time. Bright, slightly citric opening is something very beautiful, and I think quite versatile. Because of that, you can probably like wear it, I think, you know, I heard someone like that was wearing it like during summer as well. Very beautiful fragrance. Number two that made my year this year is definitely the Majestic Jardin by Alexander J. They launched a collection which I've been to the event too. I quite talked a lot about it. The bottle is absolutely, first of all, stunning. The packaging is stunning, and the price is okay for actually what it is. For the whole package that you get, the price is definitely fine. You can heads up to my Instagram, you will see I've done some opening of it, and it was really, really beautiful. Like you going to the shisha, you know, like you're going to smoke some narguilé, it smells a bit like this. There's a lot of cherry going on, so quite fruity. It's ultimate powderiness, smokiness, so it's so mysterious. It leans, you know, because it's a bit more cherry vibe, to the feminine, but honestly, I would really see that on a man too. Smoky, tone, slightly spicy, but it's all a bubble of comfort as well. And that's really what the smell that I'm gonna show you are. They're very comfortable, they're very creamy or extremely powdery. This leaves a sillage that is absolutely stunning. The performance is on point. So if you want to impress your loved one, trust me, this is so beautiful. Number three, and that's a fragrance that's part of my favorite fragrance ever, and it's Creed Royal Oud. I love this fragrance. I discovered this year, and that was one of the fragrances that blew my mind the most. It doesn't smell like very woody, it's more like a backbone. You can really smell the cedar vibe, so it's quite like woody, and also a bit of greenness, like nearly piney, a lot of spice in there. Delicate, very refined, ultimate gentleman scent, and it's something ultra versatile. You can wear it during the day, during the evening. There's a bit of depth, but it's not too much, it's not overwhelming, but easy to wear, super classy, super luxurious. The name is perfect for it, maybe not wood. It'd probably be Royal Cedar, that would be probably the best name for me, but Royal is definitely, because it's a meticulous touch. All the ingredients, you can smell this separately, and the contrast is beautiful, and it's blended to perfection. So absolutely love that. A fragrance that I had just recently, and I'm so happy too, I had it from my birthday, from my best friend, and it's Rehab from Initio. This is a bit spicy kind of scent, but you can really smell the lavender going on, nearly vanilla-like, you know, but it's very soothing and really relaxing. It's got a lot of opulence, a nice projection after it depends on your skin. For me, it doesn't like project as much as an Axos will do, or the second one I presented to you, but it does the job really nicely. Cloudy in early sillage, you really enjoy it. It's just so modern as well. I never felt something like that, and I just really enjoy the soothing touch of this lavender, and also like really spicy at the end. But it's definitely something that is round and powdery, and for me that's one of the best of the range of Initio, alongside probably with Side Effect and Oud for Greatness. But this is really love at first sniff. This one, it's just very addictive. Once you smell it, you want to smell it again and again. Number five, it would be a Floris, and it's Neroli Voyage. So you know one of my favorite fragrances is Floris Honeywood. So love this fragrance still, love it, absolutely stunning. But Neroli Voyage met my really. It's a citrus scent, so it smells like neroli, nearly like an orange blossom, you know, but a bit more sharper for neroli. It's got a marine note, so it's very unisex. Hein? Seaside vibe, it's nearly like you're walking along an Italian coast. It's quite sunny, it's a vibrant fragrance, but it's in a florist way. And florist does always the most elegant fragrance in the world. And even though it's just a fruity scent, when you smell it, you smell super delicacy, elegance. There's something a bit juicy as well, but this marine note is so relaxing. It makes me think of home because I'm from the seaside, you know. So I just love that about it, and I wear it in the morning, or I wear it on my Sunday afternoon. It's just really relaxing and invigorating, a bit give me energy without being too acidic, you know. Beautiful scent. It was one of the latest release actually, I think. Beautiful. Number six is Navitus Parfum, and it's called Virtus. I really, really love it. That was love at first sniff, and that's come by when I've met Steven from Red Alicent. So this is him that is doing this brand. And we've met when he came to London with other reviewer. I remember he gave us a discovery set, and I smelled this one, and I was just like, oh, that's definitely my favorite, far, far my favorite. It's got a milky note that is so addictive. You know, milkiness, creaminess, ultra projecting. Is not a light fragrance, it's quite heavy, woody undertone that is there to project everything, a bit spicy as well, woody, milky. I would call it a bit more sexy, but it's definitely an alien fragrance. I never smelled something like this. That was one of the fragrances that actually got me into milky fragrance. That's really a thing, you know, milky fragrance. I think if I remember good, there were things slightly exotic to it. Absolutely beautiful. That's really my crush. My crush of the year. When I wear it, I feel so unique. I feel so powerful and so different. And every time I wear it, like, there's people that are telling me, my God, what are you wearing? What's this? Because it's so unusual. If you're into fragrances, you love to see some creativity, so you're gonna love that. Seven is a fragrance I still don't have. I'm waiting for it. It's on its way to home, and it's Killian Straight to Heaven. It was alongside Rolling in Love that I absolutely love as well. Very creamy, cocooning fragrance, super sexy. But Straight to Heaven was really something I really enjoyed. Seen a good offer on Straight to Heaven, so my heart went to Straight to Heaven. Got that boozy accord, slightly green as well. So it smells like a gentleman vibe, but much more provocative. Cocktail-like smell in there that is absolutely stunning, and only Killian does those kind of fragrance. Charismatic. It's for the boss, really, this fragrance, and that's why I love in there. And it's got, I think, a touch of vetiver or something quite green, so that's why I really went toward it and enjoy really green fragrance. And the fact that there's this boozy vibe gives like something even more provocative and sexy. Definitely a head ton of fragrance. I've tried the sample on me, and the performance was absolutely amazing. Like, it sticked on my skin forever. Really recommend it if you want to try one. Killian, that was one of my favorite of the range, with definitely Rolling in Love, Black Phantom as well, that I love. But yes, number eight, film from Jo Malone, and it's called Vetiver and Golden Vanilla. So again, it's something quite warm. It's not a simple vetiver. It's mixed with vanilla, so it makes it even more unisex, and usually vetiver is difficult to wear for women. Well, this is a really easy to wear vetiver scent for ladies. I really enjoy it because it's got something really tea time, so it's nearly like you're drinking a tea. and I really love this in Jo Malone fragrance. I would love that it stays a bit longer because I feel after some time I don't really, you know, smell it everywhere I'm going, but I do love the scent so much because Nelly smell also like a candle, I don't know for what reason, Nelly like a breakfasty. Fragrance sometimes doesn't stay that long. I had good experience with some of those before, like Miran Tonka is staying forever on me. This one is staying a bit less, but I quite enjoy that though because I used to go working with it. I'm just spraying it all over my jacket and just usually feel really comfortable. It's a very reassuring scent for daytime, for winter, when it's very cold. One of the fragrances that's made my year as well, and it's Musc Ravageur from Frédéric Malle. If you know me, you've heard me talking a lot about this. This is again a vanilla scent, but it's got a lot of cinnamon, so you know that's nearly like Christmassy vibe going on. Keep projecting, there's something quite animalic to it, and it's that's why I took a little one, also because I'm broke, but you know, you don't need to spray a lot. Like I spray one or two spray in the pulse point, like on my wrist for example, and one there, and I'm done for the day. It's actually very tough and strong, so it's not something I would wear for daytime, not for a little date, I would say. No, it's something I used to wear it when I go out, when we could go out at the beginning of this year. And I want to impress, so to seduce, so it's got something ultra addictive to it, and you know, like this intense vanilla and those spices are very intoxicating. So that's the most intoxicating of the fragrance that I have in my list. And I'm really, really happy to have purchased it because it's very unusual. And this mask, a bit animalic, you know, basically very attractive. Finally, my number 10 is from L'Orchestre Parfum, and it's Piano Santal. This is one of the highlights of my year, and this house, if you don't know it, L'Orchestre Parfum, I've done a video on it. They have a very interesting concept between music and fragrance. If you go to their website, you can actually listen to music that corresponds to the fragrance you have, and it's very accurate. I remember my mom told me that she was listening to all the songs and she could picture the smell with it, and they're very clever in that, and I love that concept. Piano Santal was the first one I got really attracted to because it's again a milky fragrance. I would say a bit more delicate than Navitus, definitely in the French perfumery way, and it's all in elegant. There's something quite light going on, like it's hairy, I would say, and not hairy. It's flying, it's floating, and it's quite projecting a lot because there's ambroxan as well. So the ambroxan is pushing all the ingredients out, I would say, which is super nice. Milky Crimino is enhanced with a sharp sandalwood. And sandalwood is something like you're just sharpening a wood, but it's got kind of a softness, very unusual as well. It's very unique. And every time I smell it, it just makes me happy. It makes me comfortable, thing that I really enjoy to wear on a daily basis. So it's usually for my daytime that I wear that, but I remember I wore that on a date and it was quite working really well. Oh, come on, that's a funny joke. Really recommend any L'Orchestre Parfum. Their fragrance are blended again super nicely. You can smell a quality of ingredients, super qualitative. And if you enjoy French perfumery, delicate, sophisticated, but also effortless. So the Parisian style is elegant but effortless. There's a lot of fragrance in that range that I love, like Cuir Cora, for example, that is so beautiful, and Flamenco Neroli that I can't wait to have in my collection, and I think is at home, the home waiting for me. I encourage you to have a try, and also you will never meet such amazing team as L'Orchestre Parfum. They're absolutely stunning people. So yes, so that's my 10 fragrance that highlighted my year. I hope you did enjoy it. You can watch also the 10 fragrance that highlighted in my last year that I can put in the description for you. Please tell me in the comments which are your fragrance of the year, which one highlighted your year, did you like my choice, and I'm happy to see your comments. Yeah, I will see you very soon. Also, for the people that go onto my uTip account in the description box to give me a little tip, it's very nice. Thank you so much. I always enjoy you, and thank you because it's really nice. And yeah, bye now.